Hey everyone, I'm Kasey Funderburg, and today I'm joined by Lady Vol for Life, Aubrey Leach. Aubrey, how are you?
I'm great. Thank you for asking.
Since the pandemic, what has your life been like?
It's been very different. After, you know, COVID hit and season was kind of just canceled at a halt, I came home, which was something I hadn't been home in a while. You know, I live in Houston and Knoxville's pretty far away. So my life changed drastically, just being at home, having to figure out, you know, where to work out, where to train. I was still in recovery from shoulder surgery. And so that was like, you know, another factor to have to deal with is not only finishing school, but rehab and then being able to find a way to play in this whole mess.
Do you think your time at UT just kind of, obviously it didn't prepare you for a pandemic, but do you think it helped you with trying to, you know, figure these things out on your own, training on your own, rehabbing on your own?
Definitely. I think as a college athlete, you have to find a way not only to stick to a schedule, but to be efficient in what you do and with your time. So I do think, you know, those little things in college that set you up for success prepared me for, you know, a situation like this.
You got involved with AU Pro Sports. Tell me a little bit about that.
It was an incredible opportunity, such a fun twist on softball, and especially at the pro level, being able to kind of do almost like a fantasy sports league. And then also, you know, we were, you know, on TV, on, you know, different streaming sites, but also through DraftKings, you know, we were out there doing crazy stuff that I would have never thought softball would be. So I was really, really excited to be a part of it.
Can you go in depth a little bit more on how the league works and also explain the point system?
Mm-hmm. So we started out with 56 players and we had one have to kind of leave due to a family issue. So we ended with 57. We had one of our replacement players come in, but you have, you know, 57 players total. You all are split into four different teams every week. So there's a new draft every week. So you don't know who's your teammates are going to be, who you're going to have to play against or hit off of or that kind of stuff. And then there's points added in. So you win points for, you know, not only your offensive hits, but pitchers win points for outs. And so it kind of balances their algorithm they had to pitchers to hitters. And, you know, singles are 10, doubles are 20, so on, home runs, that big 40 that everyone was striving for. But then you also have some sack plays where you move runners over, you get 10, or a successful steal, you know, you get 10, but if you get caught, it's minus 10. So it's a little risky there. But it was fun adding some point spread into softball for sure.
Did it ever get confusing trying to keep up with all the points?
A little in the fact that like, you get points for winning innings, but you also get points for winning games. So you could lose all the innings except the last one and come back and you get the points for that last inning and the game. So not only you just like split the entire point win with that team instead of winning every inning and getting the big win at the end. So every inning counted for sure.
Wow, that's really cool. You finished 17th overall, and you were playing with some pretty high-quality players. So what did it mean to you to be able to compete with those players? And then also, what did you learn about yourself during that time?
I mean, it was a no-brainer for me when they asked, like, do you want to come play with these 56 mix of Olympians, mix of, you know, top players, mix of people, you know, I grew up hearing about. And so it was an incredible opportunity. It really was, you know, just an environment to learn. You know, all of us were stuck together for 6 weeks, and you either can be sad about it or you can sit here and you can learn and pick each other's brains and get better. And then, you know, finishing 17th was great and kind of made me think, like, I didn't think I did as well as I possibly could have. And so to finish 17th, I'm like, man, I could do better. And that's, you know, just a positive in it that, you know, I can come back and I can play with those people. I can be at the top, but also, you know, knowing that I could push myself to be even better.
How did Tennessee prepare you for AU sports?
I mean, it's very relatable to that SEC season where at the beginning of the week, you know who you're going to play. And so you have 1 week to prepare for this team. And then after, you switch to a new one. So it was very similar to that, you know, 3-game series on the weekend set up, and then you just do it again. And again, a little quicker time, and there's not as much coaching, so you have to do it yourself, which is a really neat aspect, but very similar to that SEC weekend series.
Tennessee, you know, one of the big things that the athletic department does is giving back, or the volunteer spirit, as they call it. AU Pro Sports, they do the same thing. So what did it mean to you to also be a part of a program that was giving back as well?
I think just we're in a time where people are very divided and people, you know, aren't always, you know, trusting their heart and giving what others deserve. And so to have that opportunity to not only play for myself, but to play for a cause, to be able to give back to people who are working so hard, especially in this pandemic, was incredible. And like you said, the volunteer spirit, it was an easy choice, you know, giving back to someone who really, to an organization that really cares about people. And, you know, that's what I think the volunteer spirit is. It's caring about people. It's caring about, you know, the fans next to you. It's the people who support who you support, but it's also the people who are going through what you're going through.
And this league also helps amplify women's voices. And I think we're seeing that a lot more in sports nowadays. So what does it mean to you to be a part of a league that truly focuses on the female athlete?
I will say this is probably like the most I ever felt like a professional athlete. They treated us with, you know, everything we could possibly need when it came from our innovation lab that gave us any tool we could use for recovery. When it came to our training room where we had, you know, top of the line trainers that were taking care of us. We had our own spaces. COVID wise, it was completely taken care of. We were in this shield where they, you know, cared about us. Our food was there for us, everything. And so just to be taken care of on that level is huge. And to be, you know, given what we deserve for women's sports.
Do you have a favorite memory or game that you can think of off the top of your head?
I don't know. They were all so fun. But that first week of, you know, us just being so excited to play softball was one I'll never forget. Our team, we played Orange on Jesse Warren's team. And we called ourselves the Cuties, like the little oranges. And so like just full emotion, full fun, just being able to like be in the moment on the softball field because, you know, otherwise we're quarantined. So that week was really special.
Being out there and being able to play, did it remind you of your time at Tennessee or make you miss anything about playing softball at Tennessee?
It did. So my last season at Tennessee, I was actually the student assistant. So I wasn't out there playing, and it made me realize like how much I was not ready to give up softball, like especially in that player form. And so the opportunity arose to play, and I was like, heck yes, like I'm still staying in it. I can't give it up. It just means too much.
That's awesome. So what's next for you? And then when are you going to be back on Rocky Top?
So looking into law schools right now, for next fall is kind of the path, my educational path that I'm going to take. But right now just staying in softball, coaching some teams out of this Houston area, just staying relevant, wanting to stay, you know, prepared myself for hopefully next AU season. And then, hopefully I'll be back on Rocky Top sooner than we think.
Yeah, well, I think everyone here at Tennessee, we're rooting for you. We're excited to see what your next steps are in life. But thank you so much for hopping on this Zoom today and just talking a little bit about what's been going on with your life.
Yeah, you're welcome. Go Big Orange.
Slapped into left field. That's fair. Another run will score. Moultrie rounds third. And look at Leach go. She's going to come around third. Leach looking for the inside to Parker. She's got it.